The Japanese constitution follows some of the modern principles of popular sovereignty and fundamental human rights. The history of Indian constitution. Children, the constitution of India is the supreme law of India. You would find it interesting to know that it is the longest written constitution in the world, with 395 articles and 8 schedules.
Dr. Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar is widely regarded as the father of the Indian Constitution. The Constitution of India came into force on 26th January 1950. You know that we celebrate this day as the Republic Day. The process of the evolution of the Constitution began many decades before 26 January 1950 and is continuing even till today. The Constitution of India was drafted by the Constitution Assembly. The Assembly was to have 389 members. Of these, 296 were to be from British India and 93 from the princely Indian states. Initially, however, the Constituent Assembly that was formed comprised only of members from British India. Elections of these were held in July-August 1946. The aim was to choose representatives from three major communities, Hindu, Muslims and Sikhs, as well as those from the general category. It also won 3 out of the 4 Sikh seats from Punjab. The Congress also won 3 of the 78 Muslim seats and the 3 seats from Coorg, Ajmer Merwada and Delhi. The total Congress tally was 208. The Muslim League won 73 out of the 78 Muslim seats.
The important thing to note here is that these members were elected by indirect election by the members of Urban, the Provisional Legislative Assemblies, lower house only. Since the members of Constitution Assembly were not elected by the universal adult franchise, they did not represent all sections of the Indian society. The members of princely states were not elected at all, and they were chosen just by consultation with the concerned princely states. There was a hope amongst our leaders that the princely states might join India one day, and that is why their representatives were asked to join the assembly. So, though the assembly did not represent all sections of Indian society, but it did try to take care of everybody's interests by advice and suggestions through letters, newspapers and other ways.
It took 2 years, 11 months and 17 days to draft and finalize the Constitution of India. The very first meeting of the Indian Constituent Assembly took place in the year 1946 on the 9th of December. 207 members attended the first session. The Muslim League members did not attend the meetings initially but joined later. On 11 December, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected the permanent chairman, an officer later designated as president of the assembly.
The making of Indian Constitution took several meetings of the three committees, namely the Union Powers Committee, the Union Constitution Committee and the Committee on the Fundamental Rights.
After observing the reports passed by these three committees, the Assembly went on to create a drafting committee in the year 1947 on the 29th of August. The chairman of this drafting committee, as per the history of Indian Constitution, was Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. He passed proposals for a draft constitution of India. This draft constitution of India was finally passed after several meetings held during the months of October and November 1949. On the 26th of November in the year 1949, the making of Indian Constitution was complete and was successfully passed after the signature of the President of the Assembly.
Before we go further, let us compare our Constitution with that of America. Comparison with the American presidential form of Constitution with the proposed parliamentary form of Indian Constitution.
The executive is not separated from the legislature. The members of Council of Ministers are the members of legislature. The executive is accountable to the legislature, because of which it is more democratic. In the parliamentary government, one person is head of state while another person is head of government. In such a government, the Prime Minister is most powerful. The executive is completely separated from the legislature. The legislature cannot remove the executive from power through no confidence motion. In the presidential government, the same person is head of state as well as head of government. In the presidential system, the president is most powerful. The presidential government is not completely democratic because the executive is not accountable to the legislature.